Hello, welcome to our channel Learn Mechanical Engineering. In today's class, let us solve few more problems under the topic Statics of Concurrent Force Systems. And before going to the problem, let us refresh what is concurrent system of forces. What is concurrent system of forces? Number of forces acting at a point, we call it as force system. And if all the system of forces line of action is meeting at a single point means, then it is called as concurrent force system. More than two forces, we call it as system of force. And if that more than two forces line of action is pointing at a single point means, then that system of forces, we call it as concurrent system of forces. See here, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 forces are acting or meeting at a point. Five forces line of actions are meeting at a single point, then this system of forces we call it as concurrent system of forces, and the direction of the force may be outward or inward. That's not a problem. The only thing is all the forces line of action is meeting at a single point means, then that system of forces we call it as concurrent system of forces. And if you see here in the right side, a force of F is inclined at an angle of theta with the horizontal. So as we see yesterday, what will be the adjacent component of this force, horizontal component? It will be F cos theta. So the angle which is given with respect to particular axis is cos theta. So this adjacent component or horizontal component of this force will be F cos theta, and the vertical component of this force is F sin theta. And if you see here, a force T is inclined with an angle Y. In previous case, if it is inclined with x axis means f x component is f cos theta. In this case, this force T is inclination is given with respect to y axis means y component is cos theta and x component is sin theta. So the vertical component of this T is T cos theta and horizontal component of this inclined force T is T sin theta. So always remember that if the theta is with respect to x means it is f cos theta. Here if the theta is with respect to given with respect to y means y component is cos theta. And the rules to be remembered while solving concurrent system of forces problems are, the first one is the forces which are inclined must be resolved along x axis and y axis. So by following this rule, the forces which are inclined should be resolved along x axis and y axis. So if angle is with respect to x axis means x axis cos theta, y axis sin theta. If angle is given with respect to y axis means y component cos theta, x component sin theta. Like that, you should resolve the inclined force. And the second rules to be followed is, if the forces are vertical or horizontal, then do not resolve these forces. Which means if the forces are purely horizontal and if the forces are purely vertical means, you need not resolve that force. You need not resolve the force if the forces are purely vertical or purely horizontal. If the forces are only inclined means, you need to resolve that into x and y component. And third rule to be kept in mind is sign convention. So what is the sign convention that should be given to the forces that is acting? It is similar to that of this coordinate axis. In coordinate axis, you will always take right side of in horizontal right side direction plus sign, left side direction minus sign. In vertical upward direction plus sign, downward direction is minus sign. So the same coordinate axis sign convention we are going to follow here. And if this xy axis is tilted for some angle, x also tilted for some angle, and for the same angle y axis also is tilted means, the along this x, the rightward upward direction is taken as positive, leftward downward direction is taken as negative, and along this y, upward direction is taken as positive, downward direction is taken as minus sign. So this is the sign convention needs to be followed while we are summing the forces. And now let us move on to solve a problem. So the question is, determine the magnitude and direction of the resultant force for the system of forces acting on a particle. Determine the magnitude and direction of the resultant force. So you need to convert this system of forces into a single resultant force, and you need to find out that magnitude and direction. So here, if you see here, this origin point, is acted upon by how many number of system of forces? 1, 2, 3, 4. So it is acted upon by 4 forces. So more than Two forces means we call it a system of forces. And what is the type of the system of forces? If all the forces line of action is meeting at a single point means, then it is called as concurrent system of forces. So we need to convert this, or we need to replace this concurrent system of forces into a single resultant force, and we need to calculate its magnitude and direction. And the first two rule to be followed in this solving problems in concurrent system of forces is resolve the inclined forces into horizontal and vertical component. You need to resolve the inclined forces into horizontal and vertical component. So here there are how many inclined forces? All the forces are inclined forces. 1, 2, 3, 4. All the four forces are inclined. This 100 Newton inclination is given with respect to vertical. This 50 Newton inclination is given with respect to horizontal. And if you see here, this 200 Newton and 120 Newton inclination of that force with any of the axis is not given. Instead of that, what they have given? They have given the slope of this force. The slope of this 200 Newton force is 1/2, and the slope of this 120 Newton is 4/3. So from this slope, you need to calculate this angle. So now first let us consider this 200 Newton force. So you need to find out this angle theta 1. So let this angle be angle of inclination of this 200 Newton with the horizontal be theta 1. Let this angle be theta 1. So if this angle is theta 1 means this angle also will be theta 1. The corresponding angle are going to be same. So this angle is theta 1. So we know that by trigonometry, what is tan theta 1? For this triangle, tan theta 1 is equal to vertical divided by horizontal. So vertical is 1, horizontal is 2. So 1/2 is tan theta 1. So theta 1 is equal to tan inverse of 0.5, which is equal to 26.56. So this angle 200 Newton inclination with x-axis is 26.56 Newton. So this theta 1 is 26.56 Newton. Sorry, 26.56 degree, not Newton, degree. So now similarly, we will find out the inclination of this 120 Newton force with respect to the horizontal axis. So inclination of this 120 Newton force with respect to horizontal axis, let us keep that as theta 2. So if this one is theta 2 means this one also will be theta 2 because the corresponding angles are going to be same. So what is tan theta 2? Tan theta is theta 2 is equal to vertical divided by horizontal. So vertical is 4, horizontal is 3. So tan theta is equal to 4/3. Which will give you the theta 2 is equal to 53.13 degree. So this angle theta 2 is 53.13 degree. And now we know all the four angles of the four forces. So 200 Newton force angle with horizontal is 26.56 degree. 120 Newton force with horizontal is 53.13 degree. And this 50 Newton force with horizontal, they have given it as 60 degree. And this 100 Newton force with respect to vertical, they have given it as 40 degree. So now there are four inclined forces and we know all the four directions. So the first step to follow in solving the concurrent system of forces problems are you need to resolve these forces into horizontal and vertical direction. So first force 200 Newton, we will resolve that into horizontal and vertical component. So angle is, first force angle is with respect to horizontal. So horizontal component is 200 cos 26.56 and vertical component is 200 sin 26.56. Now we will move on to second force. Second force 120 Newton force inclination also given with respect to horizontal, which is we have calculated as 53.13. So angle of these forces is given with respect to horizontal. So horizontal component is 120 cos 53.13 and vertical component is 120 sin 53.13. And now we will move on to third force 50 Newton whose inclination is given again with respect to horizontal. So horizontal component is 50 cos 60 and vertical component is 50 sin 60. And we will move on to last force 100 Newton. This 100 Newton inclination is given with respect to vertical. Now this force angle is given with respect to vertical means vertical is cos theta. That is vertical is 100 cos theta, 100 cos 40 and horizontal is 100 sin 40. So like this, first step is you need to resolve all the inclined forces into horizontal and vertical components. And after resolving the inclined forces into horizontal and vertical components, our asked question is to replace these four concurrent system of forces into a single resultant force. So we know that formula for finding out the single resultant force is sum of the forces along x square plus sum of the forces along y square. And formula for finding out the direction of the resultant force is tan theta is equal to sum of the forces along y divided by sum of the forces along x. So for to find out this magnitude of resultant and direction, we need to find out the sum of the forces along x and sum of the forces along y. So while summing the forces along x and y, we are going to follow the sign convention of the coordinate axis. X right side positive, x left side negative, y upward positive, y downward negative. So first we will sum the forces along x direction. For all these four forces, first we will sum the forces along x direction by following the coordinate axis sign convention. So first x component of first force is 200 cos 26.56. It is acting along positive of x, so plus 200 cos 26.56. And second force horizontal component is 120 cos 53.13, and that is acting along negative of x axis. So hence it is minus 120 cos 53.13. And this third force horizontal component is 50 cos 60. It is also acting in the negative of x axis. So minus 50 cos 60. And the final force horizontal component is acting towards positive of x axis. So plus 100 sin 40. Plus 100 sin 40. So this is the sum of the forces along x axis. So if you are simplifying, that means you will be getting plus 146.17 newton. So this plus sign indicates the sum of the forces along x axis is acting in the right side direction. So next we will sum the forces along y directions. So we will next sum the forces of that is acting parallel to y axis. So the first y component of the first force is 200 sin 26.56 is acting in positive of y. So plus 200 sin 26.56, and second vertical component of second force is 120 sin 53.13. It is also acting in positive of y. So plus 120 sin 53.13, and third vertical component of third force is 50 sin 60. And it is acting in the negative of y axis, hence it is minus 50 sin 60. And fourth force vertical component is 100 cos 40. It is acting in the negative of y, so minus 100 cos 40. So if you are simplifying, this means you will be getting a value of 65.52 newton. So plus sign indicates the vertical sum of the resultant vertical force is acting in upward direction. And next, we know that formula for finding out the resultant force is sum of force along x square plus sum of the force along y square. So substitute the sum of the force along x square as 156.17 square, and sum of the forces along y square is 65.52 square. So this equation will give you a value of 160.18 newton. So the resultant force to be replaced, these four concurrent system of force should be having a magnitude of 160.18 newton. So just we have calculated the magnitude of the resultant force. Next we need to calculate the direction. So we know that tan theta is equal to sum of the force along y divided by sum of the forces along x, that is v by h. So sum of the forces along y direction, sum of the force along vertical direction is 65.52, substitute that here. And sum of the forces along x direction, so the sum of the forces along h horizontal direction is 156.17. Substitute that here and simplify that, you will be getting the direction of the resultant force is equal to 24.14 degree. So you can replace this four system of concurrent force by a single resultant force of magnitude 160.18 at an angle of 24.14 degree. As of now, we have calculated the magnitude and direction. So next to find out the sense of the force, in which direction it is going to act, we need to consider this sum of the forces along x and sum of the forces along y. So the sum of the forces along x is plus 146.17. It is acting from left to right side direction. So sum of the forces along x is 146.17 newton, and it is acting from left to right. And next, sum of the forces along y is, that is, y component of the resultant force is 65.52 newton, and it is acting in the upward direction. So 65.52 newton, and it is acting in the upward direction. So this is resultant force x component sum of the resultant force x component, sum of the resultant force y component. So certainly your resultant force should be closing this triangle. So resultant force should be closing side of this triangle, and it will be acting in the opposite sense. So the resultant force direction is in this way, acting in the upward direction. So this is left side direction, this is upward direction, means resultant force closing side should be in the opposite direction. So it should be in the opposite direction. So the direction or sense of the force is in the upward direction. Angle is 24.14 degree and resultant magnitude is 160.18 newton. So you can replace this four force by a single force acting in this sense with magnitude 160.18 newton and direction 24.14 degree. So next we will solve one more problem in concurrent system of forces. So here is the description of the problem. So what they have given is the force system shown in the figure. The force system of forces shown in the figure produces a resultant of 600 newton. So the system of forces shown in the figure produces a resultant force of 600 newton. So in this problem, they have given the resultant of the concurrent system of forces, and it is acting up to the right at an angle of 60 with x-axis. So it is acting up to the right with an angle of 60 degree with x-axis. And in this system of forces, there are three forces acting. Two forces magnitude and direction is given, and third force magnitude and direction is not given. So here in this problem, instead of this force and magnitude, they have given the resultant force magnitude and direction, and they have asked you to find out the unknown force magnitude and direction. Find the values of F and theta. Find the values of F and theta to produce a resultant force of 600 newton, which is acting up to the right at an angle of 60 degree to the x-axis. So here, the difference between previous problem and this problem is, in previous problem, the system of forces magnitude and direction was given, and they were asked you to find out the resultant force magnitude and direction. Here in this problem, resultant force magnitude and direction is given. And out of this system of forces, one system of forces magnitude and direction is not given. They have asked you to find out that magnitude and direction to produce this resultant. And since in this problem, the resultant force magnitude and direction is given, we will show that here. So always the resultant force will pass through the same point of origin. So the replacing resultant force of these three forces will also be passing through the same point of origin. And they have given that it as is equal to, resultant force is equal to 600 newton. Can replace these three force by a single force whose magnitude is 600 newton, and it is acting up to the right. So from this origin, it is acting up to the right at an angle of 60 degree to x-axis. If they have given it is acting up to the left, means it will be acting in this direction. 600 newton will be in this direction, but here they have given it as it is acting up to the right at an angle of 60 degree to x-axis, means the resultant force will be acting in this fashion, which is equal to 600 newton. And here the left side diagram is equal to right side diagram. The system of forces is replaced by a single force with magnitude direction, which will produce the same effect as that of this system of forces. Then only it is called as resultant force. So this left side diagram is equal to right side diagram. And the first step to be followed in solving concurrent system of forces problem are, you need to resolve the inclined forces into horizontal and vertical component. So in left side, there are two inclined forces. You need to resolve this into horizontal and vertical component. In right side, there is one inclined force. You need to resolve this into horizontal and vertical component. And this 500 newton is purely x-axis force. So you need not resolve this 500 newton. So in the next step, we will resolve the three inclined forces into horizontal and vertical component. And if you see here in the left side diagram, the inclination of this force F is given with respect to x-axis. So the x component is F cos theta and y component is F sin theta. So this 500 newton is purely x-axis force, you need not resolve. And if you see this 240 newton inclination is given with respect to x-axis. So x component is 240 cos 30 and y component is 240 sin 30. And if you are coming to the right hand side, the 600 newton force inclination is given with respect to x-axis. So x component is 600 cos 60 and y component is 600 sin 60. And we know that this is resultant force 600 newton horizontal component is sum of the forces along x, and this resultant force vertical component is sum of the forces along y. So we can calculate the sum of the forces along x, and we can form the equation of sum of the forces along x and sum of the forces along y from this left side diagram. So, and if you come here, the 600 cos 60 is equal to sum of the forces along x. So the 600 cos 60 is equal to sum of the forces along x, and sum of the forces along x, we need to write the equation from this diagram. So first force, horizontal component is f cos theta. It is acting in positive of x, so plus f cos 60 cos theta. And this 500 newton is purely x component. It is acting in negative of x, so minus 500. And the third force horizontal component is plus 30, and it is acting in positive of x, so plus 240 cos 30. So this is the equation of this 600 cos 60 is equal to sum of the forces along x. So the x component of the resultant force 600 cos 60 is equal to sum of the forces along x, and the sum of the forces along x we have written with the help of this given system of forces diagram, that is plus f cos theta minus 500 plus 240 cos 30. So this is the equation of this 600 cos 60 equal to sum of the forces along x. So from here we can simplify that equation is as f cos theta is equal to, keep f cos theta one side and take all other term to the other side, and if you are simplifying that equation means you will be getting f cos theta is equal to 592.15. And next, by the right hand side diagram, we know that vertical component 600 sin 60 is equal to sum of the forces along y. 600 sin 60 is equal to sum of the forces along y. So 600 sin 60 is equal to sum of the forces along y of the forces on the left hand side. So what sum the forces along y direction of the forces acting on the left hand side diagram. So 600 sin 60 is equal to sum of the forces along y. So we need to sum the forces along y direction of the this given system of forces. So y component of this first force f is f sin theta. It is acting in positive of y, so plus f sin theta. And this 500 newton does not have any y component, so it will not come in the equation. And the y component of this 240 newton is 240 sin 30, and it is acting in the negative of y axis, hence it is minus 240 sin 30. Here it is 240 minus 240 sin 30. And if you are simplifying this equation by keeping f sin theta on one side and take all other terms to the other side, means we will be getting f sin theta equal to 639.6. In the next step, divide this f sin theta is equal to 639.6 equation by this f cos theta is equal to 592.15. So f sin theta by f cos theta is ff will be getting cancelled. Sin theta by cos theta is equal to tan theta, which is equal to 639.56 divided by 592.15. So if you are simplifying this equation by taking tan to the other side, means tan inverse of, we'll be getting an theta is equal to 47.06 degree. So theta is equal to 47.06 degree. And if you are substituting this theta in any one of the above equation, means we'll be getting F is equal to 873.78 newton. So you need to, the magnitude of this unknown force is equal to 873.78 newton, and direction is 47.06 degree. So if a force of this much magnitude and direction is applied at this point, means you will be getting a resultant force of 600 newton at an angle of 60 degree.